morning friends, welcome to Sharekhan pre-market roundup, first in the global markets. Yesterday at the time of our markets closing, the European markets were trading on a flat to a negative note by around 0.5%. And the American index futures were also showing a negative opening of around 50 points for Dow Jones and around 15 points on Nasdaq. By the end of the day, the European markets went down by around 1.5 to 2% across the board. And the American markets, which were at one point of time down around 200 points and Dow around 50 points on Nasdaq, recovered a bit from those levels, with Dow Jones closing down around 20 points, Nasdaq being down around 15 points, and the S&P actually being up around 3 points. This was mainly on the back of a lot of volatility which got created in the banking segment in Europe, as there was Deutsche Bank which corrected a lot yesterday, which sent the correction wave to the US banks also, but the US banks recovered off late, with Dow at one point of time being down by 200 points to being 100 points in the last hour. There was a lot of corrections here in oil stock as well. FIs yesterday were selling around 681 crore rupees in cash market, whereas FIs in index futures were buying around 600 crore rupees, whereas FIs in index options were buying by a huge around 3,000 crore rupees, which sends a mixed queue. Yesterday there were a lot of positions which got added in 7,200 and 300 put option as well. Coming to our markets, Asia is right now trading mixed, with Hang Seng being in green and Nikkei being in red. SGX Nifty is right now quoting at around 7250 to 7260, showing a negative opening of around 1% for our markets. Now let's have an update on derivatives.
Good morning friends, I'll give analysis on derivatives. In yesterday's trading session, taking negative cues from the international markets, our markets did open on a negative note, and that too with a gap down of around 30-40 odd points, and thereon we did saw Nifty continuously moving into the southward direction, as market breadth also remained negative throughout the day, and eventually it did went below 7,300 odd level also. But however, in the last 1 hour of trade, it did manage to close above 7,300. However, spot Nifty did close below 7,300, and eventually the Nifty future closed at 7,325.05 with a sharp cut of anywhere around 1% odd. On the open interest terms, we did saw an unwinding of around 3.5% odd. That is, Nifty did shedded around 7 odd lakh shares in open interest. Cost of carry, however, did increase significantly in yesterday's trade from anywhere around 1.5% to 8.5%. That is, Nifty premium shoot up anywhere from around 6 odd points to currently 26 odd points. However, we'll consider majority of the unwinding which was been observed was due to the long unwinding. And the market did see a sharp fall in yesterday's trade, due to which market participants were forced to cover up all their long positions. And it did broke the important support of 7,400, which was the highest put base. And since then, market participants were busy in covering their long positions, due to which we have seen a sharp fall of around 1% odd. Put call ratio, however, surprisingly increased, but this increase in put call ratio was mainly due to the buying of put option rather than selling of put option. We have seen an increase in put call ratio by around 3 odd basis point, from 0.79 to 0.82, indicating there was a lot of long positions was been added in the put strike price, especially in 7,200 strike price, where we especially in 7,000 and 7,200 strike price, where we have seen good amount of addition in put option, while volatility index also inched up higher in line with the market going down. We have seen a volatility index inching higher by around 7.5% from 20.26 to 21.73 levels. Now the options activity, we did saw a good amount of addition, 7,400 call option. Now 7,400 call option will act as a crucial resistance for our market, as in last trading session also we did saw a good amount of activity, good amount of call writing taking place in 7,400. And since 7,400 put option was the highest put base, it was considered as a support, and now it's been considered as a crucial resistance for our market, and it will be difficult for market to cross 7,400, at least in the short term, seeing the amount of call writing which has been taking place around the strike price. While 7,500 and 7,600 call option did saw an unwinding, the position is now getting shift, and it's been clearly visible, it's now getting shift from the higher strike price to the lower strike price. people are covering their short positions in the 7000, in the high strike price of 7600 and 7500 call option, and they are coming into 7400, which is a negative sign for our market. While in put option, 7100 put option was the was an interesting observation we did show, and significant amount of an addition of around 72 odd percentage in yesterday's trade, which was quite noteworthy. And majority of the put option which has been majority of the addition in the put option which has been seen in yesterday's trade was on the longer side. If you see, the implied volatility of the put option have also increased significantly. So all in all, market still looks weak, and today in today's trading session we did about to open on a negative note, taking negative cues from the international markets, especially crude oil, which in yesterday's trade, in the yesterday's ending of the trade, it saw around 6-7% fall in the crude oil. Due to the negative sentiments, our market is about to open a negative bias, and after that, we might see a further acceleration in the negative, in the southward direction, in the direction of the Nifty, which could more drift to the southward direction in today's trading session. There are no securities in the ban period for today's trade. On FIS terms, they did manage to be net buyers in index futures. They were net buyers by around 607 odd crores. While index options, they were net buyers by around 335 odd crores. While stock futures, net sellers by 1200 crores, and stock options net sellers by 16 crores only. On the market level, our 5 days we have stands at 7410, again 7400. 7410 is a crucial resistance as its market level. Lower range is 7200, which is the highest put base now, and position have been got shifted from 7400 strike price to 7200 put option. Hence, our lower range at 7200 and the higher range at 7410. SX Nifty again is down by 63 odd points, taking negative cues from the international markets and quoting anywhere around 7264.50, indicating again a gap down opening can be expected in the morning trade. That's it from derivatives. Thank you.
Now let's have a look at some more trading ideas and some important news flow which came after market yesterday and today morning. The first trading idea is Britannia. Britannia came out with numbers yesterday. Quarter 3 consolidated net profit being up by around 51%. At 207.6 crore YOY, net revenues due by around 10.2%. Action to be taken is long Britannia with a stop at 2722 for a target of 2861 and 2900. Auto Pharma, quarterly net profit was up around 39.2% at rupees 535 crore rupees versus 384 crore rupees. YOY, the total income from operations for the company grew by around 10% at 3495 crore rupees. Action to be taken in Auto Pharma is long Auto Pharma with a stop at 728 for a target of 765 and 780. Allahabad Bank also came out with numbers. Numbers were depressing and behind the street expectation. Net loss stood at around 486 crore rupees versus profit of 164 crore rupees. Action to be taken here is short Allahabad Bank with a stop at 52 for a target of 4940 and 4810. Central Bank was another bank which came out with numbers yesterday. Central Bank profit was also below the street expectation, with net loss being at 837 crore rupees versus profit of 138 crore rupees. This was mainly on the back of higher provisioning. Gross NPA rose to 8.95% versus 6.2%. Action to be taken in Central Bank is short Central Bank with a stop at 6324 for a target of 60.15 and 59. On the news flow, SRINS says that they are in advanced talks with Rosneft. No comment on Aramco's stake sale. US FDA has released contents of warning letter of Ipca Labs. Government will set up a disinvestment commission to push strategic stake sale in state-run companies. Will offload 20-26% in IDBI Bank through QIP. UPS found three noodles brand substandard: Knorr Soupy Noodles, Horlicks Foodle Noodles, and Ching's Hot Garlic Instant Noodles. Bharat Forge Unit and Rafael Advance signed in for JV for BMP II upgrade other systems. Coal India says that four trade unions may go for one day strike in February to March. Fortis to acquire ITC Holdings Corp for $11.3 billion. some important results which came in after market yesterday. Moil quarter net profit now 13.2 crores versus 108.3 crore. CESC net profit at plus 1% at 112 crore rupees versus 111 crore rupees YOY. Eros International Consortium net profit at 37.8 crore rupees versus profit of 109.3 crore rupees YOY. Apollo Tyres quarter three concern net profit at 51% up at 278.5 crore rupees versus 184 crore rupees YOY. Some important news flow for the day, results for the day. ACC, KPTL, Capital First, Cipla, Finolex Cables, Orbit Exports and Mandala Holidays. Stocks with positive bias are TVS Motors, C8, Bajaj Auto. Stocks with negative bias are Allahabad Bank, SAIL and PNB. Stocks for investment are Infosys, IndusInd Bank, Lupin, Sun Pharma and Ultratech Cement. That's all friends from our side. Thanks and bye on a nice session.